Can everybody hear me through the earpiece? All right, okay. Okay, so just bear with me. If you cannot hear me, just raise your hand and yeah, say that you cannot hear me, okay? So good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Kickstart Your Job Search with E2I Resume Builder and Generative AI. My name is Wei Yan. I'm from Employment and Employability Institute, and I'm a senior specialist in job matching and events innovation team, where I innovate job search with new technology like Generative AI and Resume Builder to help you with your job search. So right now, you know, all this innovation are a crucial part of our digital age, so we need to integrate it into job search. Okay? So what the topic that I'll be covering today is basically to take you through three different steps to help you build your resume using all this innovative tool. So, okay. Apologies, hold on. Okay, so what I'll be covering today, of course, I have to share with you what my organization is all about, what NTUC E2I is all about, and the three steps going to the crucial steps to kickstart your resume with Resume Builder and Generative AI. And lastly, I'll to show you that it can be done. It can be done by anyone, regardless of your age, where you are, what profile you are. I'll show you a live demo to show that it can be done in under 10 minutes. Okay, so without further ado, let me get right into it. Okay. Okay, so E2I is a tripartite initiative by National Trades Union Congress, and we are supported by Singapore National Employers Federation. So, and we also supported by Singapore Labour Foundation and Workforce Singapore and SkillsFuture Singapore, right? And our mission is to create better jobs for better life for all Singaporeans in Singapore, right? And one day we wish to be the leading organization to innovate employment and employability solutions so that our job seekers can have better jobs or better life. And we have two main career centers as of now, other than smaller centers. One is in E2I West in Jurong East. Yeah, so it's super far away from here. But yes, we have one career center that you can work in if you need any guidance or any help, whether you're an employer or job seeker. And the second one is in Central, E2I Central in HDB Hub. And it's located in Toa Payoh, where all the good food is if you're a local Singaporean. Okay? So moving on how we help job seekers, local job seekers. We help them with three things which are important in this day and age. One is job matching. So job matching is basically recruitment, your job search, matching suitable jobs with suitable our extensive network of employers. And secondly, career guidance. In this VUCA, volatile, uncertain, ambiguous environment, you need to have career guidance on how you can navigate your career forward. So we have our career coaches to do that, to help you identify your gap and close it, all right? And lastly, in the VUCA environment, you have to do skills upgrading. You need to continuously upgrade up to upskill, deep skill, and multi-skill yourself as a professional, whether you're in fintech or whichever industry you are. So this is our service offering, and our talk today is also one of the initiatives where we innovate to help you with the job matching, skills upgrading, and guidance, career guidance process. So I'll jump right into the topic. Okay. So, essentially there's three steps to kickstart your job search. And these three steps come from three challenges that we have identified from our 15 years of working experience with professional job seekers. So the first step is resume content writing. Okay, so most of our job seekers tell us that actually writing down what you do is extremely difficult. Right, so that's where in digital age, generative AI will come in to help you with resume content generation. But of course, it has to be personalized to you. So what you need is you need to know what you do and your experience, right? So that is the first step. Okay, I'll cover in more detail. And the second step, with all the rise of the technology, everybody is using technology, even HR. So we have all these systems. Even internally, E2I, we have our systems to do the job matching process, but companies are using their applicant tracking systems to screen out the candidates as the first cut, right? And also job portals itself, they are also screening out using systems. So it's essential that your system, your resume, is readable by the system. And that's why we are piloting this initiative called E2I Resume Builder to help you address this gap of creating system-friendly, ATS-friendly resumes, formatting it to a nicely format instead of going through all the Microsoft Word and, yeah, I mean, you can still use it, but this is an easier way to do it, right? And lastly, is customizing and maintaining multiple resume. Right now, we all want to go for different job roles. We don't just have one position that we desire. So it's essential that we maintain and customize multiple resumes to go for different job roles. So what I want to share with you today is also a resource that you can tap on to called Careers Finder to find relevant keywords for the role and customize it with generative AI. And we can see how it gel together with the resume builder itself. Okay, so let me get right into the first step of generating resume from scratch. So as I shared earlier, first thing first, you need to know what you have done. So with generative AI, you don't need to think of what you have done from scratch. You think of what position you held, what is your education experience. So let's say I'm a HR manager, I'm a HR system analyst. I just need to know that and which company I work at, what is my qualification, what's my educational background. And with that, we can basically put it into generative AI, right? So I have created three basic steps that you can use to generate the resume content from scratch. Okay, so the first step is prompt engineering, which other speakers will be covering extensively later. So what you need to tell generative AI, ChatGPT, or Bard to do is, can you write me a resume first, right? Based on what I'm going to input. Okay, so right here I mentioned that based on my education and work experience. After that, I will tell ChatGPT, I will follow up with my work history and for content and context. So I'll tell ChatGPT that I have a degree in physics from NUS, National University of Singapore, and I graduated in what year, and I work with what company from what year, for example DBS as a data architect for digital bank services. And of course, in this day and age, because resume is a currency, we don't need, people don't tend to read a lot. As a recruiter previously, I don't read a lot. You need to be concise and clear. So that's where you need to tell ChatGPT, I just want 3 bullet points, don't make it too long. And essentially, once you input this, you will have the output on the left side, okay? That ChatGPT write for you, okay? So at least through these three steps in ChatGPT, you can have a first draft of your resume content, right? So once you have the first draft, what to do next? So we go right to step two, where we need to format system-friendly resume, okay? So for E2I Resume Builder, you can sign up via the QR code. I will let you all scan. So it's laptop and mobile friendly, so you can scan it, but of course it requires a verification process because we need to make sure that bots are not signing up as part of our NTUC system requirement. Okay, and we also need to, we do collect personal data also as part of our requirement, but it's as per Personal Data Protection Act, so we will not share your data across. Yeah, so you can sign up. I'll give you all some time to sign up. If you cannot sign up now, you can also collect a brochure at our booth right there later on to sign up, and I will guide you through how you can sign up. Okay. So in the interest of time, yeah, you can still continue to scan. So coming back to what you have generated from ChatGPT with your work experience and education experience, you can go into Resume Builder to start creating a system-friendly resume. Okay. But the very first step when you're creating a resume is to have the contact details for employers to contact you. This one, generative AI cannot give you. You know yourself how to reach you. So what we essentially need is your phone number and your email address, LinkedIn profile, if you have LinkedIn profile, you should have. Okay, and portfolio website if you're creative. Okay, so essentially this is all you need. If you have a very beautiful, nice picture, you can put it in also. There's a space in the resume builder, all right? Okay, so once in the resume builder, once you input that information and you do it on the desktop or laptop, it's auto-populated on the right and you can see it in real time what you're inputting into a system-friendly format. Right? So contact detail, first step, necessary. If not, employers are not going to be able to reach you. right? Second step is to copy over what you have generated in the step one into the resume builder. Okay, so the keywords here is that you need to validate and personalize what you have generated. So if you're a HR business partner and ChatGPT generated a job description for you, it's going to generate the same for everybody. So what you have done, you need to personalize it. Use ChatGPT as a first draft. Okay? And you can input it in and it will do the auto formatting for you. Okay? And you can also provide additional information where relevant in different sections of the resume builder. Okay? Then it will auto format it nicely for you. So if you have any projects, let's say you're going to the financial sector or perhaps IT or fintech, you may have certain projects that you have embarked on. Then you can put it in the relevant sections also. Okay, then it will just format for you nicely. You just need to fill up accordingly and yeah, they will do up everything nicely for you. Okay, once you've done that, you can download your resume in PDF or Word format, or you can save as a draft. Right, so it will auto-save as you draft your resume. And once you have it in PDF or Word, you can upload into any system, employer or job portals, for you to at least beat the first round of screening. Because once you upload the pictures, the system will not detect. And we do have job seekers who upload a screenshot of their resume and it does not detect all the keywords. So you have to have a PDF Word format for you to beat the system. Right? So that is the second step. And the last step is about customizing and managing multiple resumes. Okay? So in this step, as I shared earlier, you do need to customize it for the different roles that you're going for. And you do need to have multiple resumes, multiple versions of your resume. And the key thing here is to customize it, you need certain keywords. And I will share with you a resource that you can tap on called Careers Finder to find these keywords and put it into resume, into relevant sections. Right? Then of course, you know, you can leverage your resume in order to create multiple versions of your resume. Okay. So, to first mine the key skills or keywords that you need relevant to the position or the position that you're in or the desired role that you want to go for, you can use a free tool called Careers Finder. It's on My Career Switcher, our national job bank. It's an additional tab called Boost Your Career. Okay? So, you can scan it if you want to check it out. You don't need to sign up, you don't need to use your SingPass. You can use it as a guest. Right? Alright, okay, so once you scan it and you start as a guest, you can go into this resume build, this Careers Finder, put in your most recent occupation or your desired occupation, and you can they will tabulate a series of skills for you based on whatever that was posted on My Careers Future. So My Careers Future is our national job bank for those who are not from Singapore. So you can use it and it will tabulate based on this whole data set that they have. And of course, once you have that, you can see all the skills, but you cannot pick all the skills to be input into the resume. Like I said, resume has to be clear and concise. So choose 5 and make sure you validate that you have these skills. Don't put skills that you don't have. Yeah. So that's the most important part. You will find like 10, 20 skills that maybe you can go for the role, but you must have it also. So that's a pro tip. You make sure that you have what you're writing. So once you have these skills, you can go back to generative AI, ChatGPT, and you can customize it in the relevant section. But my recommendation is to customize the career summary section, because as a recruiter last time, or a HR last time, I always look at the career summary section at the top. Okay. So this is where choose your keywords from ChatGPT in the same chat to customize my objective or career summary section. Okay? So once you've done that, ChatGPT will articulate it properly into a paragraph for you. Okay? So with that, what you can do is you can duplicate in the E2I resume builder, duplicate a copy, and choose whatever that you have generated, put it back in, and it will auto-format everything for you. Alright? Okay? So right now, I'll show you a demo session on how it can be done super fast. Okay, but of course, I will not show you the personalization part, so I'll show you how it can be done. OK, Okay, so the prompt that I showed you just now on how you can generate a resume, I'll copy it into the ChatGPT. Okay, and you can see the ChatGPT start generating based on your input straight away within 10 seconds or so. Okay, once you have that, you can go to the resume builder. Okay, so resume builder, you can use it, or you can use any other resume builder also. If you're using E2I resume builder, you can create a blank resume, create new, and of course you will name it. Yeah, like I said, all this personal detail you will need to input it, so I just put in a fake number for now. Okay, you can put in your LinkedIn profile, portfolio if you have, and you're creative, going for graphic designer role, whatnot. So the short description about yourself is actually the career summary section, so I will input that in. I'll copy it from ChatGPT, put it in. Alright, okay, then if I expand it, you can see that it's auto-populating whatever that I, it's auto-updating whatever that I write, whatever I input the left panel. So with that, I will continue on, so technology really has come a long way. So you can just use the systems to help you with a lot of things. So yeah, you just need to fill up accordingly. I mean, company location in Singapore doesn't really matter if you're applying for local jobs. Company description optional, unless you have a work for a big company, you have like multiple departments. Right? So if not, just input accordingly. Yeah. Alright, then the job description here. Right, this is where I'll put it in, and as you can see, yeah, it's populating, auto-populating on the left side. You can see the formatting, yeah. So you don't need to care about the formatting, like you have to in Microsoft Word, and you can use Resume Builder to do it. Okay, you just save and continue, add in education. So for education, you can put in your professional certificate or your current education. Yeah, so NUS, school location, if you want to put, you can put Singapore. Right, start margin. Accordingly, of course, I'm just showing you a demo. So, your degree, yeah, you have multi select description, you want to put as your specialization. And you have any achievement, you can input it here also. You can save and continue. Yeah. And yeah, so this part is the part where you can put in all your other projects. You can rename the title you want, the one with the organization experience. Okay. And you can save and continue. The last part I will put in for normally for Singapore context, you need to have soft skills. So ChatGPT also generated this for you based on your job role, but make sure you validate it and just input it in accordingly. Okay, so it will auto-populate on the right side, on the right panel. Okay, you just need to save and continue. Yeah, once you're ready, expand the panel, you can download as a PDF. Yeah, then once, yeah, so it's super fast, you can open it. And it's in a system friendly format, and you can straight away upload your job. Yeah. Okay. So the next step, the live demo, is actually about using Careers Finder. So you want to mine certain keywords using this resource, right? And you can go to right. Okay. So yeah. So this is a Careers Finder page. If you can find it, then you just go to Continuous Desk, select the occupation. Yep. So let's say I select this, I'll show you all the different skills. So choose a few skills that is relevant to you, and you have to make sure you validate that part. So once you have that, go back to ChatGPT to prompt it to include all the selected keywords that you have. So once you do that, I just delete this and paste it in the same chat. Okay, it will rewrite the career summary or the particular section that you are customizing. So once it's rewritten, you can use a resume builder, resume, as I showed earlier. You can duplicate duplicate the resume that you have, because you want to create a new copy all the time. You can create as many as you want. This, then you just need to copy the new career summary section. Just copy the relevant section. All the relevant keywords that you already have, and re-download. actually that is that. Okay, so that is a demo, so it can be done very quickly, but remember that personalization matters. Just don't rely too much on ChatGPT. Jeez, going back to those slides. So with that, I have actually come to the end of my presentation. And if you do need more help, like with how you can actually look deeper into resume customization, resume unique, you can check out all our resources. Okay, you can meet a career coach most importantly. You need somebody to actually run through what is a good resume, right? So you can scan the QR code if you need. If not, you want to attend our job fairs, we have a job fairs weekly, almost weekly. Yeah, so physical job fairs are still a thing. So people can come down and interact with the HR, because in digital age, it's too hard to get in touch with HR. So you can check out our panel events, but if you just want to perhaps receive job alerts, we also have a Telegram channel where you can set up one-time profile and keep applying. And lastly, if you want to check your career readiness, you can also use the E2I career assessment tool to check where you are in your career. So with that, I will end off my presentation and I will open up the questions. So I will leave the screen here for a bit so that you all can scan if you need or take a photo to check it out later. Alright? Any questions from the floor? So just speak into the microphone. I should be able to hear through this device. Just let me switch it on. Any questions? We have a mic here also, if you have any questions. Okay. If you have no further questions, and if you have more questions later, come down and visit our booth, NTUC booth right here on the right side. I'll be there with my colleague. If you want to know more about NTUC, I mean, other than E2I, we have a lot of other offerings because we have a National Trades Union Congress. Right, so do come and check it out, and yeah. Thank you so much for listening, and I hope you have a good lunch break or stay tuned for the next time. Thank you so much.